So welcome to St Alkmund's. We're recording this short service to be shown in our care homes. We're very sorry that we've not been able to come in for a few months and may not be able to for the rest of the year. So we thought that we'd record a short harvest service for you. I'm not wearing a mask because I'm speaking in church and that's allowed, but when you see some of the people here, you'll see that they are wearing masks as is necessary in this coronavirus. We've also sent this little order of service to you, so if you'd like to look at the first page and just under the heading Harvest Service in 2020, you'll find two responses and you say the words that are in bold. So in memory, remembering that it is harvest time, praise the name of the Lord.
Ascribe greatness to our God.
Lord, open our lips,
and we shall praise your name.
And next comes a recording of a hymn that will be very, very familiar to you. So I'm not sure that you'd be allowed to sing, but if you're not, hum along to it. You'll find the words on the service sheet. It's the hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful.
Satisfied, but ignore the cry of the hungry. Father, in your mercy,
forgive us and help us.
We are thoughtless and do not care enough for the world you have made. Father, in your mercy,
forgive us and help us.
Words of forgiveness. May the Father of all mercies cleanse you from your sins, restore you in his image to the praise and glory of his name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And it's very much linked to harvest time, and Jane is coming to read that for us. Thank you, Jane.
Psalm 104. You make springs gush forth in the valleys. They flow between the hills, giving drink to every wild animal. The wild donkeys quench their thirst. By the streams, the birds of the air have their habitation. They sing among the branches. You cause the grass to grow for the cattle, and plants for people to use, to bring forth food from the earth, and wine to gladden the human heart, oil to make the face shine, and bread to strengthen the human heart. O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Thank you. I wonder what harvest memories, harvest time memories, you may have. For some of you, you may remember working in the fields at harvest time. Some of you, it might be harvest suppers, especially the apple pies. Others, it will be harvest services in church or chapel. A thing that runs through all of those, and probably through all of your memories, is thankfulness. Thankful for getting in the harvest, security for the winter. Thankful for time to relax and enjoy eating with friends. Thankful to God for the great variety of fruit and vegetables, of crops and pulses. And that Bible reading that we heard, that comes from someone with a thankful heart, acknowledging God's goodness to us and his whole creation. In particular, gladdening and strengthening our hearts. So let's ask God this harvest time for the grace of thankfulness, to notice what is good, what is helpful, what is beautiful, and give thanks for it. We come now to our prayers, and if you look at the right-hand side of the inside service booklet, you'll be able to follow the words and join in with the response. Pauline, thank you.
Lord God, we pray for your world, that we may share and conserve its resources, and live in reverence for the creation and harmony with one another. Father, Lord of creation,
in your mercy,
yes. In Christ you call us to a new way of life, loving our neighbours before ourselves. Help us to treat the world with care and respect.
In your mercy,
yes. We thank you for the work of all who provide us with food to eat, the farmers, the processors, those who provide transport, those who prepare and cook. Bless them in their work and in their leisure.
In your mercy, hear us.
We carry on in our prayers by joining together in the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine glory, for ever and ever.
Amen. Coming towards the end of our service now, perhaps the best known harvest hymn, and you'll find the words on the back page, and so we'll listen to and hum along, follow the words in our minds to the hymn, "We plough the fields and scatter the good seed on the land." And remain with you this day and always. Amen.